Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about gestosis, the continuity. Okay, now I am going to explain about the characteristics of the gestosis. In this gestosis, actually the symptoms that edema, proteinuria and the high blood pressure happening after the 20th week of gestation, and then BP, blood pressure, usually it should be more than 140 and 90 millimeter Hg. Another characteristic is proteinuria, that is 3 gram per liter protein should be present in the one day of collection of urine. And de novo, that is synthesis of fatty acid, it may be happen after 20th week of gestational age. Now let me see the pathogenesis. Actually the cause of gestosis is unknown, still it's not going to be specified. So the unknown cause, it's causing the pathology of a placental artery. In this placental artery pathology, decreases the blood flow of placenta. So it has giving three results. The first one is decrease the secretion of vasodilators and increase the secretion of vasodilators and placental insufficiency. For a space, I wrote these three things here. Let me come here. So decrease the vasodilators and increase the vasodilators. Increase the vasodilators and placental insufficiency as giving some effect. In the vasodilators, somehow it is giving the spasm of the arterioles. So in this spasm of arterioles, they are giving the endothelial damage. So in the endothelial damage, they are activating some bradykinin and all. So it's permitting albumin to pass from the intracellular space. So in this case, albumins are passing to the intracellular space and decreasing the water. So it's giving edema. The next step, because of the water is so low, it gave hypovolemia. Hypovolemia activated the renin angiotensin system. Then renin angiotensin system gives the high blood pressure. Another thing, endothelial damage giving the filtration of albumin in the urine. So we are getting proteinuria. This is the pathophysiology of the gestosis. This is what I am trying to tell in this video. Thank you.